some information about Bert Morisot's life. Bert Morisot was a French Impressionist painter who was born on January 14, 1841 in Bourges, France. Bert Morisot's father was a high-ranking government official, and her grandfather was the influential Rococo painter John Honor Fragonard. She and her sister Edna began painting as young girls, despite the fact that as women, they were not allowed to join official arts institutions. The sisters earned respect in art circles for their talent. Bert and Edna Morisot traveled to Paris to study in copyworks by the old masters at the Louvre Museum. In the late 1850s, under Joseph Guichard, they also studied with landscape painter Jean-Baptiste Camille Corot to learn how to paint outdoor scenes. Bert Morisot worked with Corot for several years and first exhibited her work in the prestigious state-run art show, The Salon, in 1864. She would earn a regular spot at show for the next decade. In 1868, fellow artist Henri Fantin-Latour introduced Bert Morisot to Edouard Monet. The two formed a lasting friendship and greatly influenced one another's work. In 1874, Bert Morisot married Manet's younger brother, Eugene, also a painter. The marriage provided her with social and financial stability while she continued to pursue her painting career. Able to dedicate herself wholly to her craft, Morisot participated in the Impressional exhibitions every year except 1877, when she was pregnant with her daughter. After her husband died in 1892, Bert Morisot continued to paint, although she was never commercially successful during her lifetime. She did, however, outsell several of her fellow Impressionists, including Monet, Renoir, and Sisley. She had their first solo exhibition in 1892, and 2 years later, the French government purchased her oil painting Young Woman in a veil gown. Bert Morisot contracted pneumonia and died on March 2, 1895, at age 50. I am holding right now one of the best artworks of Bert Morisot entitled The Mother and the Sister of the Artist. It is created on 1869 to 1870. It took her one long year to finish this artwork. Its dimensions is 1.01 meters by 82 centimeters. She used oil paint and canvas to make this artwork. This artwork is entitled Eugene Manet and His Daughter in the Garden. It is created by the painter Bert Morisot on 1883. Its dimension is 60 centimeters by 73 centimeters. She uses oil paint to conduct this artwork.
And here is the third one. Artist name: Bertie Morisot. Title: The Harbor at Lorient. Date: 1869. Size: 45.5 by 73 centimeters. Medium: oil on canvas. All time on, baby, don't hurt me, hurt me, hurt me. You know I like it naughty, naughty, naughty. And the last one is The Woman at Her Toilet. Date: 1875 to 1880. Size: 60.3 by 80.4 centimeters. Medium oil on canvas. What you gonna say? You act like you gon' mean, but I know that you gon' say. Break it down, dig it down, down, girl, don't even play. How did she make her artwork? Bert Morisot's style was consistently and typically impressionist. Her paintings were full of color and light, and she perfectly mastered the technique of painting fleeting shades and shadows. Morisot's work highly influenced by the types of artwork women were encouraged to produce small compositions in pencil, gouache, or watercolor paints. Bert Morisot art career. Bert Morisot was a French Impressionist painter who portrayed a wide range of subjects, from landscape and still lifes to domestic scenes and portraits. Bert Morisot challenges in life. Her husband died in 1892. Bert Morisot continued to paint, although she was never commercially successful during her lifetime. She did, however, outsell several of her fellow Impressionists, including Monet, Renoir, and Sisley. Bertie Morisot triumphs in life. She first exhibited her work in the prestigious state-run art show, The Salon, in 1864. She would earn a regular spot at show for the next decade. In 1868, she met Edouard Manet. In 1874, she married Manet's brother. The marriage provided her with social and financial stability while she continued to pursue her painting career. Bertie Morisot's social contribution. In 1864, she exhibited for the first time in the highly esteemed Salon de Paris, sponsored by the government, and judged by academicians, the salon was the official annual exhibition of the Académie des Beaux Arts Paris. Her art was selected for exhibition in 6 subsequent salons. Until in 1874, she joined the rejected Impressionist in the first of their own exhibitions, which included Paul Cézanne, Edgar Degas, Claude Monet, Camille Pissarro, Pierre-Auguste Renoir, and Alfred Sisley. It was held at the studio of the photographer Nadar.
Throughout her career, Berthe Morisot had to fight against preconceptions of women and their role. She was highly unusual in her decision to be an artist, as well as a wife and mother. But many people inevitably saw her primarily in her traditionally female roles. Therefore, until recently, it has been assumed that Manet was the master and Morisot was the student in their relationship. But it is certainly arguable that they influenced each other in different ways. Although she has been forgotten in some corners, Morisot was an important figure in the founding of Impressionism as a movement. She participated in their first exhibition and was a key artistic and social figure within their circle. Morisot was also a strong, encouraging influence on other female impressionist painters living in Paris at the time, such as Mary Cassatt and Eva Gonzalez.
I got this girl, she don't go to school. I got this girl, she don't go to work because she twerk,